Hello, my name is Eiko Pras. I'm a professor at the University of Twente, the Netherlands, where I teach networking. In this video, I'll take you back to the origins of SNMP and explain how we moved from the first internet management protocols around 1987 to SNMP version 3, which became a full internet management standard in 2003. In this video, I will introduce and explain initial technologies such as HEMS HEMP, CMOD, SNMP version 1, version 2, and version 3. We'll also interview some of the core SNMP developers. In the second half of the 1980s, the internet was growing fast and the necessity to develop management standards became apparent. The first standard appeared in October 1987, and that standard was called HEMS HEMP. HEMS was standing for High Level Entity Management System, and HEMP was for High Level Entity Management Protocol. 1 month later, so November 1987, SGMP, the Simple Gateway Monitoring Protocol, appeared. This protocol was slightly changed into the SNMP Simple Network Management Protocol. Work also was going on a third proposal, which appeared in April 1989 and which was called CMOD, Common Management over TCP. Soon it was agreed that three competing proposals was a bit too much. Therefore, it was decided to stop the activities on HEMS HEMP. Work continued on SNMP, which was considered to be the short-term solution, and CMOD, which was seen as the final solution that would eventually replace SNMP. CMOD is basically the internet-specific version of CMIP, which is defined by the ISO OSI. At that time, many people believed that OSI protocols would finally also replace the internet protocols. It seemed therefore a wise idea to already work on a smooth transition towards OSI. Since SNMP was considered to be a fast and simple intermediate solution, progress of the SNMP proposal towards an IETF standard went relatively fast. The first draft was published in August 1988, and by May 1990 SNMP got accepted as full internet standard, with standard number 15. Around the same time, also the related SMI and MIP2 definitions got accepted as full internet standards. Work on CMOD, however, progressed slower, also since collaboration with the responsible ISO OSI working group was needed. CMOD became proposed standard in October 1990. SNMP became immediately widely implemented and deployed. Since SNMP had several shortcomings, such as weak security and relative poor performance when large amounts of management data needed to be retrieved, people started to work on improving SNMP. For that purpose, two groups were established. The first one focused on security of the initial SNMP protocol. SNMP had a very weak form of security with passwords called community strings flowing unencrypted over the network. The second group focused on other aspects such as performance and called their proposal SMP. After some time, the SNMP security and the SMP groups were merged into the SNMP version 2 group. Around that time, it also became apparent that OSI protocols would not automatically replace the Internet Protocol Suite, and work on CMOD was therefore stopped. The status of the CMOD proposal was moved to historic. Let's hear to Dan Ramaskanu, who has been IETF Operations and Management Area Director for many years, to learn why CMIP and thus CMIP over TCP failed.
Why did CMIP fail?
I believe that the first, there is always a combination of timing and industry status. So I believe that at that point in time, let's say the state of art of implementation into devices was not up to coping with the complexity of CMIP. I think that things had happened 10 years later or today, the landscape would have been different. But at that point in time, SNMP was simple enough, but not simpler than it was necessary to provide the basic functions of management. And I believe the situation is still there, at least for some of the applications that we are dealing with in the internet. And of course, for things that SNMP is not sufficient or insufficiently well defined, people have invented other protocols and other applications. Some are in the standard space, some are in the proprietary space.
Initially, the work on SNMP v2 progressed well, and in April 1993, the working document got proposed standard status. Note that proposed standard is, after working document, the first step towards a full internet standard. To replace community strings, SNMP version 2 introduced the so-called party model. Parties were needed to administrate encryption and authentication keys. Although the party model was quite powerful and versatile, it was relatively complex to understand and implement. In the next period, many vendors and universities, including the University of Twente, started to implement the SNMP v2 protocol. This turned out not to be too simple, and intense discussions took place at the working group meetings at the IETF, as well as over the SNMP v2 mailing list. In 1995, two of the original authors of the SNMP v2 proposal publicly announced that the party model was too complex and needed to be replaced by a simpler model. The result of that announcement was a complete disaster. The IESG, the Internet Engineering Steering Group, therefore decided to remove all new security functions from the SNMP v2 proposal. At the end, SNMP v2 therefore got the same community-based security mechanism as SNMP version 1. Let's listen to Bert Wijnen, who is one of the core developers of SNMP, to understand what went wrong with standardization of SNMP version 2.
Can you tell a little bit more why SNMP version 2 failed?
I think in one word it would be complexity. We were struggling with how to do security. And so one of the things that I didn't even mention yet was a party-party context, which was trying to abstract the OID identifications into usernames. So the username got translated into an OID, and that way you would know which parties were talking to each other, and they had security certificates and all that. And that was ended up to be so complex that it was, to begin with, difficult to implement, but quite a few implementations did exist. But if you had to explain to users how to do this, there was so much code that you had to write around that it actually didn't work. We needed security, and then at some point, Glenn Waters came with a idea. Guys, we can do this very, very simply, and we basically encode the security information into the community string that we had at the time. And that sort of split the SNMP v2 effort into a SNMP v2 star and SNMP v2 U component. The v2 U was following Glenn Waters' initial idea, worked it further out, and still became more complex than the simple thing that Glenn had. And the v2 star guys, who in my view were trying to do too many things, too much administration and all that. So that, in my view, was even more complex than the V2U. That's why I chose the V2U side. That, in the end, also failed. It became more or less a war between the two fractions as to what to do.
Despite the fact that improving the security of SNMP V2 did not succeed, many other improvements did succeed, such as new PDUs, better error handling, and so on. The IESG also decided to form a new working group to still add security to SNMP. Interestingly, the key players behind SNMP v2, thus the people who failed to come to an agreement, were left out of this new working group. For obvious reason, the working group was called SNMP version 3. The task of this working group was to take the good ingredients out of SNMP v2 and develop a simpler security model. The SNMP version 3 working group called this new security model USM, User-Based Security Model. The SNMP version 3 working group progressed relatively well, and SNMP v3 got the status of proposed standard in January 1998. In April 1999, the SNMP version 3 proposal was further moved towards draft standard. Finally, in December 2002, SNMP version 3 became full internet standard. At the same time, also the SNMP v2 protocol operations, upon which SNMP version 3 was built, was also moved to full internet standards level. Now that finally a secure version of SNMP existed, the community-based SNMP v2 variant was moved toward historic status.